In today's video, the most dangerous signs and symptoms of kidney disease most people fail to notice. Some say that kidney disease is a silent disease because it doesn't have symptoms in the early stages. Well, truth is, there are symptoms, but they are hard to spot, sometimes even for competent doctors. But there are two very important things that can make it a lot easier for you or for your doctor to understand if the foam you see in the urine or the back pain you may have are actually caused by kidney problems. Today, I'll show you what these two things are. My name is Catherine and I've been working with kidney disease patients for 7 years now. If you're new here in OO Kidney, welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell. There is a very important thing I need to tell you before I start. There is a select group of people who may need the attention of a healthcare provider immediately if they have the symptoms I'll show you today. While everyone with one or more of these signs should get tested, if you're part of this group of patients, you will need to take action even sooner. So, let's not lose another second. Let's see what the signs of kidney disease most people fail to notice are. The very first symptoms we need to talk about are those of the urinary tract, like foam in the urine. Let's take the example of foam in the urine. This is, in many cases, the very first symptom of kidney disease, but unfortunately, it's very hard to spot it. People generally mistake it for the normal bubbles they see in the urine. Now, when foam is caused by protein leakage or proteinuria, it can mean there's a problem with the kidneys. Okay, so how can you tell if it's protein in the urine or just normal bubbles? Normal bubbles are bigger, clear and flushable, and everyone will have bubbles in the toilet after urinating. Foam, on the other hand, is white and it stays in the toilet after you flush. This can be a sign of protein in the urine and kidney damage. Now, getting diagnosed only with this symptom is almost a good thing. It means you got diagnosed in time. So, if you see a foam similar to what you can find on the top of a freshly spilled beer, that definitely could be proteinuria, especially if the symptom becomes more noticeable over time. Now, there are other changes in the urination patterns you should be on the lookout for. Changes in the urination patterns are very frequent and very important signs of kidney problems. They are nocturia, meaning waking up at night to urinate. This is a symptom of kidney problems more often than people realize. So, if you get up 2 or 3 times at night and you feel lots of pressure, especially at night, it could be a sign, but also urinating less often or in smaller amounts than usual can be caused by kidney problems. And urinating more frequently than usual is another symptom, just like a feeling of pressure while urinating and difficulty urinating. Now, there are two other symptoms in my slide here. Dark colored urine and blood in the urine. These are marked with an asterisk, meaning that you should see your doctor immediately if they happen. Now, looking at this slide, it is clear that when there is something happening to the way we got to the bathroom, the kidneys may be responsible. But these symptoms often go unnoticed because they could be caused by a lot of other very frequent conditions of the urinary tract. Unlike the next symptom, this sign is one of the few symptoms that is hardly not caused by kidney problems. Let's see why. Kidney pain. Okay, this is another symptom of kidney disease already present in stage 3 of CKD, at least in some patients, which means it could be useful for an early diagnosis, because if you're just having foam in the urine or other urinary problems, well, it could be nothing. They can be caused by a UTI, enlarged prostate, kidney stones, bladder stones. But if one of these symptoms is present at the same time as kidney pain, well, it's different. Now, it's very important not to mix up kidney pain with back pain or muscle skeletal pain. How do we tell if it's kidney pain or a back injury? Muscular or skeletal back pain is usually in a slightly different location from kidney pain. Back pain caused by a back injury is usually situated in the lower back. The kidneys are located towards your back inside the rib cage. So, kidney pain is usually in a higher position than back pain. If you feel the pain coming from inside the rib cage, it may be from the kidneys. But if it's coming from outside the rib cage, it's usually from the muscles. Another way to understand if it's kidney pain or just back pain is looking at the other symptoms you may have. So, let's see. Fatigue. Okay, we are looking at the different kind of symptom now. Like for the symptoms of the urinary tract, this one could mean that kidney damage has already progressed. It could mean that the kidneys have already lost about 50% or more of their function. But we should distinguish between fatigue, which is a symptom, and being tired, which is normal and happens to everyone. And this makes particularly hard to identify fatigue as a sign of kidney problems. Now, fatigue is a term used to describe an overall feeling of tiredness or lack of energy that doesn't go away. It isn't the same as simply feeling drowsy or sleepy. Being sleepy or tired is usually solved with a good night of sleep, but chances are that if fatigue is the cause, it may be almost impossible to sleep well. Another symptom often present at this stage is feeling cold when others are warm. If you feel cold all the time, even in a warm room, it may be a sign. And just like fatigue, this symptom is caused by anemia. What is anemia and why is it important? Anemia is so frequent in people with kidney problems that the symptoms it causes are also signs of kidney disease. Anemia is a condition in which you lack enough healthy red blood cells to carry adequate oxygen to your body's tissues. This will make it very easy for you to get out of breath, okay? Even just getting up out of a chair or walking across a room can make you feel tired. Other symptoms of anemia include fatigue, headaches, problems with concentration, paleness, dizziness, difficulty breathing or shortness of breath, and chest pain. Of these, one very frequent in people with kidney problems and anemia we should know more about is chest pain and shortness of breath. When kidney disease is present, extra fluid in the body can build up in the lungs, making it difficult to breathe. Anemia can compound this issue further because there aren't enough red blood cells to accept and transport the limited oxygen a person breathes in. So, it's not unlikely for kidney disease patients to be out of breath even without doing any activity. Now, when fluids start building up, it means that kidney disease is already progressed to the advanced stages. This happens when the kidneys cannot remove fluids anymore from the body. And unlike the very light symptoms of the early stages, the symptoms of stage 4 and 5 of CKD are very noticeable. So, let's see the most dangerous symptoms of kidney problems. These are only present in the advanced stages. Swelling. People with kidney disease in the advanced stages of CKD will experience this symptom, swelling or edema, if you want to use a medical term. Swelling is more frequent in the ankles and feet, but this symptom can even interest the hands, abdomen, and chest. Swelling is caused by uremia, A severe decrease in kidney function can lead to a buildup of toxins and impurities in the blood. This is what nurses sometimes call urine in blood. The kidneys cannot filter the blood well enough, and the substances that should have been removed in the urine are still in the blood instead. Dialysis is mainly used to treat this condition. Uremia is what's causing the most dangerous symptoms and complications of kidney disease. Swelling is one of them, but there's more. We'll see the three most dangerous in a moment. And I mentioned in the beginning of the video that there is a select group of patients which may very likely need to take action faster than anyone else. Who are they? Those with one or more risk factors for CKD. Let's see what the risk factors are. These may be even more important than the symptoms. These risk factors are the very first thing you should pay attention to, because this is what's actually causing the damage. So if you have any of the symptoms I've shown you in this video, the first thing you have to check is if you have any of these risk factors for chronic kidney disease. They are diabetes, high blood pressure, heart problems, and high cholesterol, but also obesity. Then there's family history of kidney disease, being a smoker or being 60 years old or more. If you have one or more of these, don't wait, get checked. Find out what the problem is and start to treat it as soon as you can. Now, there are three other symptoms worth knowing. Rashes and itchy skin. Rashes and itchy skin are symptoms caused by uremia too. When toxins accumulate under the skin, they cause uremic pruritus, a painful itch. This symptom is usually present in the more advanced stages. So if you only have rashes or itchy skin, it could be due to other conditions too. Another symptom of the advanced stages is metallic taste in the mouth. Uremia can also make food taste different and cause bad breath. A person with kidney problems may even notice a peculiar metallic taste in their mouth. They may suddenly stop liking to eat meat, or they may lose weight because they don't feel like eating and have nausea and vomiting. Severe cases of uremia can cause nausea, vomiting, and a complete loss of appetite. This is a serious complication for patients with kidney disease because it can cause severe weight loss, on top of all the other symptoms we have already seen. These were the most dangerous signs. Let's hope you don't have to get diagnosed due to one of these. Okay, so now we have a more complete understanding of the symptoms of kidney disease. I've told you at the beginning of the video that there are two things that can let you know very easily if the symptoms you may be having are caused by CKD. The very first is having one or more of the risk factors I've shown you. And the other thing is having several symptoms at the same time. If one of these two things happen, don't wait, get checked immediately. Now, my hope here is that this video can give you a better understanding of how to prevent the gradual loss of kidney function caused by kidney disease. So, thank you for watching, and as always, I want you to prioritize yourself. Take care of you and do all your best to live your healthiest life. A new video is coming next Tuesday. Don't miss it. Goodbye.